Hey guys, greetings from Gili Trawangan.
We're in this together. We're in this together.
Hey guys, I'm in Bali, Indonesia. It's 2 a.m. and I have to whisper, otherwise I'll wake everybody up in this hostel. Like I said earlier, it is almost 2 a.m. and I'm going on an adventure that does not involve drinking. I'm going on a sunrise trek to Mount Batur, but I'm not entirely sure what that is, so maybe I should look that up first. Holy shit, is this what I signed up for? Look at this thing. Well, I guess I better limber up.
You are the one that is always by my side. You are the one that I've never tried to hide. You are the one that is always there for me. Me and you, you and me, in our small infinity. You are the one that is always on my mind. You are the one that I'd never leave behind. You are the one that'll always hold my hand through the good and the worst, you and me until the end.
I think we're calling it, there's no sunrise. What the hell? Well, crap, I guess it's time to go back down. Hey guys, it's 4 a.m. and I'm sitting here at the Indra Lounge at the Jakarta International Airport. I have a flight to catch in about 10 minutes. I am on my way to Hong Kong. But before I do, I thought I wanted to answer some questions because I owe all of y'all from last vlog. So here are the answers to some of questions I got in celebration of 50 days of travel. My favorite meal definitely has to be the Bugs Café in Siem Reap, Cambodia. Who knew crickets, silkworms, and ants tasted so good? Now, beer is a different story altogether. I'm a big craft beer drinker, and all the beer I've had so far is glorified piss water. In Vietnam, I had Bia Saigon. In Cambodia, I had Angkor. And here in Indonesia, I had a lot of Bintang. I mean, they're all pilsners, they're all okay, but they don't hold up next to a good craft beer. I am super thankful that they are cheap and refreshing on a very, very hot day. Hey Hus, thanks for the question. It's actually a really good one. Personally, I did not buy any souvenirs. My pack is already so damn heavy that the thought of adding to it makes me cringe a little and my back tense up a little bit. A lot of my souvenirs are digital in nature. I take a lot of photographs and make vlogs like these that I'll probably play back and reminisce on the fun time that I'm gonna have on this trip. Thanks for your question. The things that I've found to be super helpful are waterproof cases for your smartphone and dry bags. If you plan to spend a lot of time around beaches, rivers, or any water, it's always a good idea to have protection for your smartphone because you will always have your smartphone. If you get caught out in the rain, it's always a good idea to have protection for your smartphone, Android or iPhone. So those are the two things that I found to be super useful up on my trip so far, and it's something that I recommend to someone who is traveling long term. There you have it, guys. I got a scoot, I got a flight to catch. See you in the next one.